And a good Monday, everybody. My name is Jewel, and this is J7409 Weather. Thank you so much for clicking play and checking out all of the weather with me today. We're going to start out with the tropical outlook and the update here. First of all, though, it is October 12th, 2020. I know if you're like me, I forget the dates a lot. I like to stick them in here. But we still have disturbance number one right here. Now, I really don't think a lot's going to go on with this. Let me see if I can get all of the forecast in for you. Just want to make sure you can see what's happening here. Now, showers and thunderstorms with this tropical wave, still a tropical wave. It's about 750 miles east of the Windward Islands. It's continuing to show signs of organization, and the chances have gone up just a little bit. If it were to turn into something, it would be called Epsilon. Now, slow development of this system is possible during the next day or so while it moves generally westward around 15 miles per hour. But folks, I'm telling you, I don't think it's going to be a threat or turn into anything for anyone. Very strong upper level winds are expected to limit the further development by midweek. In 2 days and 5 days, it does have a 30% chance, looking like it's going to be a big rainmaker. As we look at the latest satellite data, you can see right here, here is the system. But these cloud tops, they're not very filled with anything, okay? Just rain, rain, rain. And it looks like what's going to happen, it's going to go up over this way, but it's going to diminish. That's what it's looking like now. Everybody in the island area expect, and maybe Puerto Rico, maybe even the Dominican Republic, I don't think it'll get that far before it lifts up because of a trough coming through. But everyone in these areas right in here, the northern chain of the islands mainly, primarily, expect rain out of this. Maybe some wind, shouldn't be anything you couldn't handle, maybe 20 to 30 mile per hour wind gust. But you are going to get some rain out of this. But do not worry. I will keep my eyes on it. And if I see any changes, I will be sure and post them. Looking at the power outages that Delta left behind, we'll start here in Texas right now. Still, as of right now, 36,126 people without electricity. Poor, poor state of Louisiana, 194,530 people without electricity. And over in Mississippi, we have 16,446 people without electricity. So far as severe thunderstorms popping up today, it's looking kind of low, looking good. Most of the lower 48's looking very, very good. However, though, we still can expect these pop-up rain showers and thunderstorms that may happen all the way up from Upper Michigan, Lower Michigan, Wisconsin, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, Pennsylvania, New Jersey, Long Island, coming on down Delaware, North Carolina, and mid-south to southern Florida, all the way down to the Keys. No tornadoes are expected, no high wind gust, and no hail. This would be your average pop-up thundershower activity for today. The big news coming, stick around. It's going to get much, much colder for many of us. I always thank you guys so much for watching, sharing, liking, all that good stuff. But for those of you who are into the weather and you haven't subscribed yet, please do so. Click subscribe, click the bell, then make sure you check off all. If you don't check off all, you won't get all of my videos as I put them out. That's just a YouTube thing. So remember to do that, and I would appreciate it very much, and I thank you in advance. Yes, my friends, enjoy the warm temperatures right now, because by this weekend, many of us are going to feel a huge, huge cool down, all due to a broad upper level trough. It's going to look like the dominant feature over the entire 2/3 of the country with below normal temperatures. And it's coming in this weekend. Now, I have the temperature gauge here set for Saturday at midnight. Still fairly warm, nothing too bad. Let's click it on through. Look at the temperature start to fall, and look at this cold front. This is not wind chill. This is Fahrenheit temperatures, as you can see. Look at this, man. It's going to get cold, everybody, up in these areas around Minnesota. 25, 24, 26. We move up into North Dakota, 26. Wisconsin, in the low 20s to mid-20s, I should say, to low 30s, all of these areas. Little strip coming down from New York, right in this area here. 29 degrees in North Carolina in the mountain areas, but that's not anything, folks. We're going to click on through. As you can see, the timestamp, we're still at Saturday. For the warm temperatures, let's go back highs in the 60s. I'm used to 70s and 80s right now. And down in Florida, you guys are going to be in the 80s. Move up a little further north, say midsection northward. You're going to be in the 70s. Panhandle for daytime highs are going to be in the upper 60s. Texas, you're going to get a cool down also, but not as drastic as some. But let's keep on moving through. I want to just show you guys this so you'll be prepared for this weekend. Now, Sunday, you can see the temperatures start to fall. Over here, we got some 40s in North Carolina over where I live. 48 degrees. Hoo-wee. I haven't seen that yet this year, but it's on the way. And as you can see, looking like New Jersey, 46 in some places. It's going to be a big cool down as this big system starts to move on through. We're still on Sunday. Sunday high should be in the 60s, maybe 69 as you move a little further south in the 70s. But folks, we got a cool down coming. Don't get caught short by it. You're going to see anywhere from probably 10, 15, maybe 20 degrees cooler in a lot of places around two-thirds of the country. Now for general weather for the lower 48, what's going to happen in the next 3 days, today through Wednesday? This is the future radar right here. You see the time stamps up here. You see the date here. I'm going to turn it on and let you know what's happening, folks. The remnants of Delta will deliver some more heavy rains to parts of the East Coast through Tuesday. Now, we got a deep low pressure system. It's going to spread rain and thunderstorms from the mid-Atlantic to northeast through Tuesday, and rain and higher elevation snow for the Pacific Northwest and Northern Rockies. Now, the remnant of Delta's really gone now, but it's going to continue to ascend up the East Coast today because it's going to redevelop into a coastal low pressure system. Now, heavy rain and some isolated thunderstorms will spread out across the mid-Atlantic and Northeast Coast through Tuesday. Meanwhile, we got another deep low pressure system. It's going to bring rain and scattered thunderstorms to the Midwest today and eventually the Northeast by tomorrow, as it's going to interact with a coastal system. Now, the heaviest rainfall is forecast to remain mainly offshore, except for coastal Maine, where coastal Maine could get up to 2 inches of rainfall through Tuesday. Now, we got active pattern. It's going to be bringing some rain and high elevation snow to parts of the Northwest today and particularly tomorrow. Now, a deep low pressure system is looking like it's going to arrive at the doorstep of the Pacific Northwest tomorrow morning and dump a couple of inches of rain at the lower elevations, as heavy snow will be falling in the higher elevations of the Pacific Northwest and Northern Rockies. We have an elevated risk of fire weather still, my friends. It's in effect today for parts of the Front Range and Central Plains, as dry, above-average temperatures, windy conditions will persist across this area. And, of course, all of these areas have red flag warnings in effect as of now. Temperatures are forecast to begin warming up again across the southern plains and southwest Tuesday, but like I said, for many of us, and I showed you, at least two-thirds of the U.S., a big cool down's coming this weekend. So if you like the cooler weather, it's coming our way. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you so much for watching, liking, sharing, subscribing, all the stuff that you do. I appreciate it so, so very much. And may each and every one of you Have peace, love, and kindness in your lives today. Thanks for watching.